This is insane. What the hell are we doing, giving these sand rats our food and water?
Orders are to keep the prison fully operational.
What orders?
We haven't heard from the mainland in months. Everything's dead. Our flashlights are dead. How do we know there even is a U.S. anymore? These rations should be for us. If anybody starves, it should be them.
It sounds like you're proposing treason, Corporal. So how about I throw you in one of them cells? Would you like that?
No, sir.
Must be half the U.S. government. Looks like Washington's come to us.
Most of you know me. My name is Jack Davis, U.S. Secretary of Defense. You are here because you were vetted and chosen. An historian once said, a great civilization is not conquered from without until it has destroyed itself from within.
I saw that quote in the Mel Gibson movie.
That is what happened to us. But it wasn't the blackout. Long before that, our nation was ruined by perverts and parasites. I believe the blackout was our punishment, but I also believe this is our chance to atone. Make no mistake, gentlemen, I am proposing a coup. Air Force One went down. We lost the president, the speaker, most of the senior staff. Once we handle the vice president, I am the next in line. While we sit here and wait out the purge, we are going to lose 70% of our population. You may think that's a tragedy. I see it as natural selection. The tide will ebb. The weak will die, but the strong will survive. And we'll build a new America committed to the ideals we believe in. Like it says on the dollar, right under the pyramid, Novus Ordo Seclorum, a new order for the ages.
Sir, even if we're able to convert the other soldiers on the base, the mainland's a different story.
Plans are in motion. For one, my assistant secretary, Randall Flynn, is making preparations, and this gentleman is going to help us win hearts and minds. Victor.
Thank you, sir. I'm Victor Doyle. I'm a consultant with the DOD. I specialize in interrogation and re-education, and I can promise you that whether people join us willingly or not doesn't really matter, as long as you know how to apply pressure in all the right places.
For those who have been watching in frustration as our once proud nation withered and died, this is your moment. You will be the new founding fathers, remembered and hailed forever.